for you this is almost a little bit of a home race. You said beforehand your qualifying actually went quite well yesterday on the third row. What are you expecting from this race? Do you think it's going to be quite close?
Yes, will be really, really tough this race, and but they're really looking forward to it. It will be a big fight, big group, but I will give everything today.
Do you think people are going to keep up with Brad Binder? He looked so strong so far.
Yeah, he have a really good pace, but I think it's very, very difficult. But if someone can break away, it's him.
And finally, Philip, these hotter conditions, is that going to make it more difficult for you guys with the tyres?
Maybe a little bit, but the tyres, I think, should be really good at this racetrack. And I think we will have really good tyres also at the end of the race.
Thank you very much, Philip. Good luck.
So Joao Mir starts from pole. Brad Binder will start second. Philip Hertl hit the nail on the head there. If there is anyone that's going to break away, it will be Binder. And Bastianini will start third.
Yeah, Binder's been pretty good at expectation management this weekend, though. He's been pretty adamant all weekend that it will be a big group battle. 20 riders, he feels, could be in contention for the podium. There's Aaron Connect, who had a pretty lackluster Friday and Saturday morning, and then he really came on song in qualifying yesterday afternoon. He ended practice in 27th place. Nothing to suggest that he would be as high as fourth on the grid, as he was a 136.661, pushing Connect onto the head of that second row of the grid. A couple of front row starts already for him this year, including one last time out in Germany. Just needs a decent point scoring finish, Steve, because there's been a couple, well, more than a couple actually, of squandered opportunities from Connect this year.
Yeah, there has. This could be a day that he looks forward to. Although he didn't look that happy on the grid, did he? Here's a man that is pretty happy, certainly a lot happier than he had been in the first half of the season. Fabio Quartararo, a pre-season favourite, didn't pan out that way. And he's got equaled his best qualifying position since the opening night of the season in Qatar.
Yeah, let's not forget, of course, we just saw a special dedicated KTM grandstand. Of course, this is a massive race for KTM, for Red Bull, the circuit owned by Red Bull. Huge pressure, really, on Brad Binder. You know, he rides for KTM, he's sponsored by Red Bull. Big chance for him to score some pretty big brownie points with his backers and his manufacturer.
And the big test is, I'm not sure if we'll actually get a camera as far back as 17th on the grid, but this is the big test for Jorge Navarro, second in the championship. The Spaniard has a lot of work to do. This could be the making of Jorge Navarro with a decent result here today, but an awful lot of work to do, and he's carrying injury.
Pekka Bagnaia, sixth place on the grid for the Italian, of course, race winner at the Dutch TT in Assen. Lots of talk of the fallout of the whole Romano Fenati Sky VR 46 scenario. That's opened the door for Pekka Bagnaia possibly to move up to Moto2. There was some talk that they were already planning to run a two-rider effort with Fenati and Bagnaia next season. But here we are, Nicola Buliger, part of what is now a depleted Sky VR 46 team in seventh place on the grid. Dylan.
Yeah, guys, I thought I'd just bring you to the front of the grid. We have a highly concentrated Brad Binder here, so I'm going to talk with Aki Ayo instead. Aki, Brad has looked absolutely fantastic all weekend. What's the tactic going to be? Try and run away with it from the start?
maybe there is, let's say that for sure, there is A, B and C at least, but he felt whole weekend quite confident. Okay, this morning when it was a lot humidity, he didn't feel so good in breaking point, but I think the condition is better now. Than if he feel good since beginning, I think he's trying to be in front, and then we see after a few laps, of course, maybe after third race or something, if he can stay in the front and how big is the group. That if group is still there behind, for sure, I think, then just have to play with the group and attack in right moment in the end.
Okay, fantastic. Thank you very much, Aki.
Well, that is one of the big question marks of this race. Can Brad Binder make a breakaway from the chasing pack at the front? Fabio the Gian Antonio, the impressive rookie, equaled his best qualifying result of the season in ninth place. Keep a close eye on him. He's already had a couple of podium finishes. Bo Benschneider's really coming to prominence as well. Gained a lot of experience and knowledge in that first half of the season, which he's now ready to put to good use. Qualified inside the top 10. Really tight qualifying session again yesterday afternoon. Just over a second covering the top 21. Down from Joan Mir in pole to Andrea Migno in 21st place.
BMW M2 safety car rolls away from the line for its quick shakedown lap. Make sure that we're all ready to go. Won't be long now before the warm-up lap begins for this Moto3 race. Dylan.
Yeah, just a quick word on the tyres. Everyone is on the same combination, medium front, medium rear, so this race is not going to be decided by choice of rubber.
Thanks for that, Dylan. There is Joan Mir then on pole position for the first time. He looks really confident, happy, jovial on the grid there. There's Jules Danilo, Frenchman, who's had a really strong season so far and looking to follow it up here with another bunch of points.
Yeah, never had a top 10 finish prior to 2016. Jules Danilo, he's had four already in seven or eight races this year, so it has been really impressive from the Onjeta River Cold Honda rider. There is Jorge Navarro. Worst qualifying performance for him since he was 18th on the grid in Mugello back at the start of 2015. Quite rare to see him outside of the top 60. I think you mentioned him warm up this morning. I don't think it's very rare. I don't think he's ever qualified outside the top 60. Certainly not this season.
Not this season at all, no. Here's Nico Antonelli, of course, back from his collarbone break at Germany a month ago. Lots of people putting him on Brad Binder's bike for next season. Looks like he might be riding for the Red Bull KTM IO squad in 2017. But it is going to be an interesting race. On the front row, number 33, the beast, Enea Bastianini, on great form at the moment, the championship leader, the man with the target on his back is second, Brad Binder. But on pole here this morning in Austria, it's Spain's Joan Mir.
So round 10 of the 2016 Moto3 World Championship about to get underway. A debut pole for Joan Mir, the Spaniard, ahead of the World Championship leader Brad Binder. Bastianini completes the front row. Canet, Quartararo and Bagnaia, that's your second row. Buliger, Philip Hertl and Fabio De Gianantonio on row 3. Bo Benschneider, the Dutch rider, heads row 4, ahead of Jules Danilo and Nicolo Antonelli. Martin Guevara and Locatelli on row 5. Darren Binder, Jorge Navarro, second in the World Championship in 17th. And Gabriel Rodrigo, who's shown some impressive form of late, he's in 18th place. Bezzecchi, the wildcard, Mino and Loy on row 7. Manzi, another wildcard on the Mahindra in 22nd. Cornfile and Ono completing row 8. Noradin, Albert El Reynas and Kyril Idan Power, the Argentine Grand Prix winner, a German Grand Prix winner, way down at the back of row 9. McPhee, Valtellini, Herrera, row 10. Ramirez, Suzuki, Spironelli on row 11. And all on his own on the 12th row of the grid. Completing this 35-rider lineup at the Red Bull Ring, it's Lorenzo Petrarca, the Italian.
Nero Giardini, Motorrad Grand Prix of Austria begins. A 10-corner circuit, 7 right-handers, 3 left, 7 braking zones. And there will be 23 laps of this 2.6-mile circuit for the younger generation in Grand Prix racing. And they have a packed crowd to race in front of here. Look at that on your right. A lot of the grandstands have been given flags so that you can see the sort of Austrian flag there and the colours, the red and white in the grounds. Just spectacular scenes here. These riders, of course, are used to big crowds. They won't be fazed by that. They will have to keep their eyes on that Red Bull KTM South African rider Brad Binder, who turned 21 earlier in the weekend and is looking to take away with him the best birthday present ever. Don't forget, folks, 4 Grand Prix races in the next 5 weeks. One of the most important parts of the season so far coming up. Try and stay injury-free. Try and close the gap on this man that we're on board with here.
Brad Binder will be keen to get back to winning ways. No win for him since Mugello, which ended a sequence of 3 successive wins for Binder, of course, including that great fight back from 31st place on the grid in Jerez. Work to do for Jorge Navarro, but if he's looking for inspiration to come from 17th into the leading pack, well, look no further than Binder in Jerez a few months ago. As you say, Steve, crucial part of the season, the second half of this championship. 9 races coming up in 14 weeks. And really, with Romano Fenati suspended by the Sky VR 46 team, we've now got really effectively a 2-horse race for the World Championship. Binder in the ascendancy on 159 points. Jorge Navarro leading that chasing pack, 47 points adrift. You can forget Fenati now. He's already 66 points back of Binder and missing this race and possibly that suspension running further than this Red Bull Ring clash in Austria. Well, Romano Fenati's slim World Championship hopes, well, they have completely evaporated now.
Brad Binder might be favourite, but Joan Mir is on pole position. And to sum up this Moto3 championship, it's now 14 races since a rider has won from pole position. Can Joan Mir change the records here today and set them straight for the Austrian Grand Prix? All 34 riders make their way onto the grid. Valentino Rossi there, just on the side of pit wall, tracking his riders. Can they get themselves a victory here today? As we prepare for a 23-lap race here, the green flag waves at the back, and now we look to the lights in the top left corner here, back in Austria for the first time since 1997, and we are underway. A good start from Brad Binder and Aaron Canet, also number 44 from row two, and here Bastianini from third on the grid now challenges Binder immediately. Joan Mir will not get the whole shot. It is the championship leader, Binder, who gets away first. Exactly what they didn't want to see, Matt.
Yeah, very tight at that first corner. Looks like all 34 riders were safely through. Mir lost two places then on that run up the hill to the first corner. Canet stays in fourth. Can't see where Fabio Quartararo is. He was fifth. He's already lost three places, the Frenchman. Mir fights back on Binder, as does Bastianini. Binder pushed immediately back to third.
Bastianini leads as they exit turn three and now plunge downhill into turn four. Bastianini from Mir, from Binder, and then a bit of a gap back to Aaron Canet. This could be a freight train if they can beat up Binder early on. Mir fancying a move already. Binder looking up the inside, but they stay the same for now. Bastianini in front.
Yeah, Quartararo was pretty sluggish from that fifth place on the grid. As we said, he has dropped back down to eighth place. Bagnaia moved up a spot into fifth. Bastianini then still leads the way. Bagnaia then picks off Aaron Canet at turn number six. They'll start that drop down the hill then into one of only three left-hand corners through turn seven. Mir putting the pressure on Bastianini. Bastianini holds firm as they sweep through turn eight.
The top three just branching out a bit here from the rest of the pack, but if Pecco Bagnaia can get in on the action, he is more than capable of staying with them and fighting for the victory. It's Bastianini still from Mir as he feints a move up the inside. We're coming towards the end of lap one then into turn 10. Try and stay in the track perimeters here as we make their way onto the stuff. And Trey Bagnaia has made a mistake. He's fallen back a couple of places, but across the line for the first time, it's Bastianini with Mir in his slipstream.
Yeah, the top three already 1 second clear of the chasing pack led by Canet. Fabio de Gianantonio has been the man on the move on that first lap. De Gianantonio up from ninth, already into fourth place. He picked off Canet in the slipstream coming over the start-finish line. So the Grazini Racing rider now leads that chasing pack.
Well, on board of Bastianini, he lost a place to Mir, but here he comes on the slipstream, uphill into turn three. One of the tightest corners on the calendar, but he can't outbreak Mir, can he? Or it will be tight here. Will Mir close the door? Yes, he does. It is Joan Mir, the pole sitter, that has the advantage from an air Bastianini, and Brad Binder now closes in.
Yeah, Mir gets great drive on the gas coming out of turn number three. He's taken four or five bike lengths out of an air Bastianini. Bagnaia is desperate to get to the front of that chasing group because he can see these three moving across in the distance. Binder's a bit wide at turn number four, got it a bit moving around on the front end and into that corner.
Yeah, he recovers well. He went up the inside of Bastianini and he couldn't make it stick, and so he just recovers there, slots into third place. Of course, the group behind will be hoping this lot beat each other up a bit in the early stages so they can then get on the back of this train. Quartararo then just up behind Bagnaia. He needs a big result here today.
What's happened to Aaron Canet, Steve? Because he was running in fourth at the end of the first lap and he's now been dropped back down to 10th place, so he's been picked off by six riders on this lap. Quartararo now has got himself into fourth place. Mir's been able to open up a gap now of almost half a second as they come round turn 10 to complete this second lap of 23.
The world championship leader Brad Binder now successfully manages to get past Enea Bastianini and chases down the race leader across the line. That was a really good lap from Joan Mir, a 37.350, but Quartararo, his teammate, was the fastest man on circuit that last time around. Jorge Navarro, second in the championship, currently in 14th. And now we exit turn one and look at the slipstream that Brad Binder's trying to get on Joan Mir.
Yeah, Quartararo means business. Steve said fastest on the track, just ahead of Mir, as Binder got the toe to move up the inside of Mir on the brakes down into turn number three. No, Joan Mir's really, really strong in the braking zone, that sharp rise up the hill into turn number three. Quartararo's 0.8 of a second back of this lead trio.
This will really test the racecraft of the rookie Joan Mir that leads, because Brad Binder has stacks more experience and already here looking to go up the inside. This is where we went wide earlier. Not so this time into turn four, and Brad Binder leads from Joan Mir. We're on board here with Bastianini. Mir gone really wide there, made a mistake, maybe missed a gear. Bastianini through to second.
Yeah, big mistake as he came through turn five for Mir. So in the space of two corners, the Spanish rider relegated back to third place from the lead. It's Quartararo from Bagnaia, the Gian Antonio, and Philip Hertl in that chasing pack. Aaron Canet's lost another place, so struggling in the early laps is the teenage Spaniard. A bit further down behind Canet in 11th is Danilo, 12th, Ben Schneider, 13th. Jorge Navarro, we haven't mentioned him, he's only moved up three places from his grid spot, so the aggressive first couple of laps that Navarro needed, he hasn't really been able to deliver so far.
Yesterday, when looking at the race pace, and now Bastianini was quietly going about his business and put in a series of really quick laps. He can keep the pace at the front. He's looking for his first win since Misano last year as he pulls out of the slipstream and goes past Brad Binder. And now Mir goes from third into second as he just nudges the championship leader and down to third place.
Yeah, Mir got a great two-bike slipstream coming down that start-finish straight. Quickest man on track now is Anea Bastianini. Quartararo's he's lost another couple of tenths on that last lap now. Quartararo 1.1 seconds behind the lead trio in fourth place. Quartararo himself is just putting a bit of daylight between fourth place. Binder gains aggressive at turn number three on Juan Mir. Quartararo is coming right back into this podium battle now.
Yeah, well, more moves like that from Binder and Quartararo will have his chance. That was the classic block pass there from Binder. But unfortunately, they just lost a tenth to Bastianini out front. Mir fights back immediately. He's got the inside line. This could be close. His front wheel almost touches the rear of Brad Binder again. That's advantage Bastianini out front.
That's as close as you're going to get between Mir and Binder without actually having any contact. And while these two are scrapping it out, one, it's giving Bastianini the chance to make a bit of a break at the front. And two, it's giving hope to the likes of Quartararo, Bagnaia, Philip Hertl and the Gian Antonio behind. The Quartararo now is right on the back wheel of his Leopard KTM teammate, Juan Mir. Philip Hertl runs it in a bit hot through turn number eight. That's cost him a bit of drive now as he comes down this downhill drop to turn number nine. It's really starting to tighten up again in this lead group. It was a breakaway at the start of the race between Binder, Bastianini and Mir. But that chasing group of five or six riders back to Boudiger and Locatelli, they're coming right back into podium contention. End of lap four.
There's some real fighters in that chasing group as well. If they can get up with this lot, we're in for a humdinger of a race. Across the line we go. Bastianini's lead has already gone. Brad Binder, the championship leader, flies through. Mir in third. Quartararo really with them now. Remember, he's not had a podium since Assen last year, desperate to get himself on those top three steps again.
Massive difference in the pace of Quartararo and Hertl last time around compared to those leading riders. On that sweep now, up through that fast kick at turn number two, Mir's got the inside line. Has he got the late braking technique to get under Bastianini? No, he hasn't. Bastianini holds firm. Last time around, Quartararo and Hertl, the only two riders in the top five into the 136s. They were 8, 9 tenths of a second faster than this lead trio.
Watch this move here, the block pass from Mir. He basically repays Brad Binder the favour, exactly what happened to him from Binder a lap earlier. Juan Mir here is doing the rest of the pack a huge, huge favour because they are really now in contention. It is Juan Mir in third place, but Bastianini that leads from Binder. Fabio Quartararo still there in fourth place.
Navarro, quick check on the Spaniard's progress. He's up to 12th place now. He's just picked off Livio Loy and Jules Danilo. The gap between the top nine, the top 10 really, that are effectively in this podium battle. Bastianini the leader down to Andrea Locatelli, 2.4 seconds as Binder has a look up the inside of Bastianini. He's through this time around, no problem for Binder. He's had a few troubles getting through these turn number four.
Here we go into turn number 10 and onto the start-finish straight. Brad Binder it is that has the advantage with Bastianini in second place. Juan Mir there in third, trying to get into the slipstream. Look at Binder, look, he's weaving around, trying to hope that he can now break away. Philip Hertl's having a great race so far. There he is, number 65, the German rider, who classes this as his home race, effectively, because it's closer to him than we were in Germany. De Gian Antonio in sixth place. Then in seventh, it is Bagnaia and Martin, who's having a great ride.
Yeah, fastest man last time around was, in fact, the number 88 of Jorge Martin. Quartararo then back up the inside of his teammate, Juan Mir. Has he just run in a little bit wide? No, he hasn't.
Binder made a mess of that on the exit. It looked like he might try and break away, but he was out on the curbs, and that now means that Bastianini is alongside him. This will be the chase now, downhill into turn four. who will break the later. It's Bastianini up the inside, and he leads again and sits up the championship leader, Brad Binder.
Yeah, and that was mighty close between the two Leopard teammates, Quartararo and Juan Mir. They almost contacted each other down in the brakes for turn number four. Binder thought about a look up the inside of Bastianini at turn six. No way through this time around. That was a really, really close call between Quartararo and Mir. Philip Hertl's come right back into contention now in fifth place.
We are then. It is number 33, the beast from the east of Italy. Romano Fenati, of course, not here. If you've just tuned in, he has been punished by his team, and so the championship in the moment, well in favour of the man that now leads again, Brad Binder, number 41, as they drop down into turn 10. He will go across the line, the leader. Will he go into turn 1, the leader, though? Because look at this, like, all in the slipstream. We've had a faller, one of the wild cards, unfortunately, the Mahindra rider, number 53, Marco Bezzecchi, down at turn 4.
Quickest man last time around again in that lead group was Jorge Martin, now in sixth place. He's the only rider in that lead pack now down into the 136s. So he's upwardly mobile, Martin, 2014 Red Bull Rookies MotoGP Cup champion.
Bastianini didn't get the drive he wanted out of the turn number one, but it doesn't seem to have made too much of a difference. Binder it is that will lead into turn three from Bastianini, Juan Mir and Fabio Quartararo. Philip Hertl close, and Fabio Gianantonio almost got it all wrong. He drops back a few places.
Yeah, he got him way, way too hot, the Gianantonio there. He's dropped now back behind Martin, Bagnaia and Bulliger. Did pretty well to gather it all up, ran off track. We've also lost Tatsuki Suzuki, the Japanese rider's crashed out. There's been a couple of close calls, certainly in the braking zone down for this turn number four. Binder and Bastianini have nudged each other, so have Quartararo and Mir. Mir is back in third place now, and looking up the inside of Bastianini. Beautiful move. Bastianini's out wide, Bastianini's well wide. Mir and Quartararo sweep through at turn six.
Another faller, Tatsuki Suzuki is down, and Philip Hertl tries to pick off Bastianini as well, who's now dropped down to fourth place. So it's Binder at the moment from Mir and Quartararo. There's a leading group of six at the moment, and this is a replay of the crash for Tatsuki Suzuki. It's been a tough weekend for him anyway. Qualified in a season worst 33rd yesterday, and he'll look forward to Brno next time out.
Jorge Navarro's going to be kicking himself, Steve. He's just last time around did a 137.4, which was the exact same pace of Brad Binder, but he just hasn't been able to make any impression. Navarro over the line to complete lap number seven. It is Binder from Mir. Binder strong on the brakes into that first corner. There's Martin. He really is a man on the charge. Up the inside brilliantly of Bastianini in the first corner. So Bastianini's just dropping back a few places. Jorge Martin's never had a top six finish in his Grand Prix career. He's looking to put that record straight today.
The top 10 are covered by 2 seconds, and then it's the gap back to 11th place rider Jorge Navarro as Fabio De Gianantonio now slides up the inside of Brad Binder and leads. Brilliant move there from the Frenchman. It looks like he is well and truly back to his best form again.
Yep. Textbook block pass by Quartararo going up the hill at turn number three, Dylan.
Just a quick word on Jorge Navarro. You're saying he's now getting a bit quicker. The team have just confirmed to me, so he is also on painkillers, not the injection type, but the pill type, which could wear off at halfway. So you could argue that now is the time where he really has to push as much as he possibly can.
Yeah, Navarro, just in the background there, is trying to shake off the advances of Livio Loy. He needs to get past him and see whether or not he can close the gap down to this leading pack.
Well, if he can get clear track and get into his rhythm, which he clearly has, then while this lead group of 9 or 10 riders keep bashing each other up, then it's not beyond the realms of possibility that Navarro can claw his way back into contention. He's certainly got time, 15 and a half laps to go here at the Red Bull Ring.
Juan Mir there thought about a move up the inside of his teammate. Philip Hertl now is up into fourth place, number 65, up ahead of Jorge Martin. And then now Bastianini, who's had a really horrible couple of laps. We're about to go across the line with 15 to go. A long, long way left in this race as yet. The championship leader, though, Brad Binder, as ever, continues to be the sharpest of the bunch. He leads, but fastest man on the circuit on that last lap, Gabriel Rodrigo in 14th.
Yeah, 136.848, 6/10 of a second quicker than the race leader, Brad Binder. But Gabriel Rodrigo is marooned down in 14th place, trying to find a way by Bo Benschneider. Two abreast now as they come up the hill to turn number three. This is where Quartararo took the lead last time around. Nobody can find a way through on the Frenchman this time. Philip Hertl got it a little bit messy. Martin was also out wide.
Quartararo it is that leads from Brad Binder. Philip Bertel moves up into third place, up ahead of Joan Mir now, who won't want to fall back any further. Jorge Martin really is having the ride of his life. Mir up the inside of Bertel into turn four. Looks really strong on the brakes, doesn't he, Joan Mir? Looking in great form here.
Yeah, he's got a rock-solid front end, Mir. He's made a few really nice overtakes at turns one, turn three, downhill in the braking zone for turn four. Quick checking on a couple of other riders. Nicolo Antonelli, of course, race winner at the opening round in Qatar, recovering from that broken collarbone he suffered in Germany before the summer break. He's down in 22nd place. And Kyril Inampawi, winner 4 weeks ago in the rain conditions in Germany. Well, he's having a nightmare here in Spielberg, down in 29th place.
With 15 laps to go, the leader is Fabio Quartararo from Brad Binder. Joan Mir desperate to try and join his teammate now at the front of this race with Philip Bertel, the German, looking for his second ever podium. Then a bit of a gap back to Enea Bastianini. The top four here just starting to break away as we cross the line.
You talked about Navarro having to deal with Livio Loi. Well, he's dealt with Livio Loi, so Navarro now is up to 11th, which means he's got clear track now to this lead group of 10 riders. There he is, Navarro, under pressure from Ben Schneider and Livio Loi. But now he's got clear track, Navarro. He'll be hoping he doesn't get slipstreamed on this run up to turn number three. What's the gap then between that? Well, 10th place is the Gian Antonio. Yeah, well, 2 seconds back is Navarro. So he's got time.
He's got time, but he's got trouble as well. There he is, number nine, Jorge Navarro, just about staying ahead of Livio Loi, who dives up the inside of Bo Benschneider. This is the battle for 11th place.
Tell you something, a great ride. It's Maria Herrera there. She's on the number six, KTM. She's in the point-scoring places, the only female rider in this field. Of course, broke her left wrist only 4 weeks ago in Germany, so this has been a real stellar performance from Herrera.
Navarro has been picked off by Livio Loi and almost loses the front end. Navarro then gets bumped wide by Bo Benschneider. This is not what the doctor ordered for Jorge Navarro. It's not going to happen. And just to make matters worse for him, Brad Binder has got out front and has got, what, a tiny bit of breathing space, shall we say? Fabio Quartararo in second. Philip Bertel now up to third. This is the moment where Brad Binder, when we were watching the other pack, went up the inside of Fabio Quartararo. Classic move there. I mean, just completely halted all the momentum from Quartararo.
He did, yeah, just squeezed Quartararo out onto the curbs. No way that Fabio Quartararo could commit to the corner and turn in. Binder's out a little bit wide, though, coming through turn nine. He's got to be a little bit careful of that. Of course, if you do exceed the track limits, race direction will be more than happy to hand out penalties, but we're about to complete lap number 10. It's Binder over the line. Best lap of the race from Binder. That's been matched by Bastianini. So Bastianini set a new lap record, 136.763. Still looking pretty menacing, the beast there in fifth place.
These guys in second, third and fourth have got to be incredibly careful here what they do, because Brad Binder is the rider that everybody's pointed out as the man that could potentially break away from the pack. And look at them, they're all squabbling for second, third and fourth, and that will only help Binder get away. They need to work together.
Navarro's done the hard work again to get back by Ben Schneider and Livio Loi to 11th place. And he's got 2 seconds to hunt down Pecco Bagnaia on the Mahindra, who's just at the back of this lead group.
What a ride this is from Philip Hertel in second place. This is just completely different to what we're used to seeing. The German rider had a good start to the season, but after injury, and the two Leopard KTM riders really need to have a word with themselves, because they are slowly ruling themselves out of contention.
Not for the first time in this race. Quartararo and Mir have got tangled together at turn number four. Yeah, Philip Hertel hasn't had a top 10 finish since the third round of the season. That was when he was that brilliant fourth place from pole position at the Circuit of the Americas in Texas. He got bugged on the last lap for the podium by Brad Binder. But he's looking really good at the moment. There's Pekka Bagnaia in 10th place at the moment.
Struggling to stay in contention is Pecco Bagnaia. Philip Hertel still in second place. Bastianini in third. See what that gap is at the front when they cross the line next time. Binder trying to open up a lead.
Steve, you wonder what Jorge Navarro could do once he got clear track in front of him. Well, he's doing a great job. He's taken half a second out of the Gian Antonio on this lap. Another lap record coming in, a 136.665 from Enea Bastianini. Mir's up the inside of him, though, at turn number one. Thank you very much, Joan Mir. He's not shy, he's pretty aggressive. He's got race-winning experience at a fairly high level in World Championship race. Of course, he won 4 races in the Junior World Championship last year. Bastianini's going to get a great slipstream on the run up the hill to turn number three. Can he make a move stick? No. Mir too strong on the brakes. Quartararo. Oh, he mugs them both. What a move by Fabio Quartararo. Brilliant by the Frenchman. Up the inside of Bastianini and Mir.
Well, Bastianini there just saying, guys,
calm down.
We're trying to catch Brad Binder here. Let's just keep this really simple, but it's not happening. Look at them. The pair of them are just like hyenas, aren't they, in this pack? The two Leopard KTM riders. Let's see a replay of it. Quartararo from nowhere outbreaks a lot of them. Really did well to get that stopped, and then just gives his teammate a bit of a nudge for good measure as well.
Well, I suppose the only thing you can say is they're swapping the same paint. But you know there's trouble. You know that they're interfering with each other a lot when you've got the beast and Ayo Bastianini saying, calm down.
Bastianini, the conductor there, just saying, come on, boys.
This is going to be giving a bit of heart, though, to Andrea Locatelli, the third of those Leopard KTM riders, because he's in sixth place. He's just breaking up a fraction now behind this lead group of five. And Mir again up the inside of Bastianini.
He will not go away. He runs wide out onto the outside of the track limit. But for now, Bastianini regains. But it's going to come back again. Here comes Joan Mir. These guys, Matt, they're going to fall out of the race here. This is just ridiculous that Joan Mir and Ayo Bastianini and Fabio Quartararo, already you can see that Philip Hertl has left that group.
Well, I've just been up and down pit lane checking the pit boards of Joan Mir and Fabio Quartararo, so there's certainly no instructions on them to tell them to stop fighting and get into the rhythm.
I think even if there were instructions on the board, these teenagers would probably say, yeah, not interested. Just going for it.
There's Navarro. Look at Navarro.
Brilliantly done here by the Spaniard.
He's through already on Bagnaia, the Gian Antonio, and Buliger.
Taps his rear seat unit there to Nicolò Buliger and says, work with me and we'll be good. Here we go now on board with Nicolò Buliger. That's Jorge Navarro just up ahead.
Last time around, Steve, Navarro was 1.5 seconds faster than Bagnaia in 10th place. 1.5 seconds he took out of that group in front of him. So Navarro is the man on the charge. Is it all too little too late in terms of the podium battle? He's got work to do. 11 laps to go. He's now ahead of the Gian Antonio.
We have 11 laps to go. It's Brad Binder that leads from Philip Hertl. The gap keeps on fluctuating, really. Hertl in sector two, really struggling to stay with Binder, but then he closes it up again when they get to the straights. This is Fabio De Gian Antonio, number four you're looking at, in the battle for eighth, trying to chase down Jorge Navarro. Up ahead of him, Jorge Martin.
Navarro's only 1.2 seconds behind Jorge Martin, who himself's only 3 tenths behind Andrea Locatelli. There's a bit of a gap then, about 1.5 seconds up to Joan Mir in that lead group of five. So Navarro's got time. If he hasn't cooked his tyres trying to fight through the pack in the first half of this race, he's up to eighth now. He's just put in his personal best lap of the race, a 1:36.8. He's lapping quicker than Binder and Philip Hertl, the top two in this race now, Navarro. So we'll keep a close eye on the Estrella Galicia Honda rider.
What's happened to Philip Hertl? He's fallen. Look at this. Bastianini and Quartararo have worked very well to get up to Philip Hertl.
Well, they've probably started riding with their heads, Steve, and started stopped beating each other up and just thought, right, let's get into a rhythm and get this gap closed down, because Philip Hertl, Quartararo's out wide. It's getting incredibly tight, incredibly messy up at that third corner. And all this is doing, Brad Binder won't know it, but it's giving him a bit of an opportunity to open up a gap for about 3 or 4 tenths of a second. He's got a bit of daylight now between himself and Quartararo, who's back in second. Brilliant move by Bastianini on the brakes up the inside of Philip Hertl at turn number four.
And now Bastianini and Fabio Quartararo have the pace to be able to keep with Binder, but they're going to have to stop all this squabbling if they want to try and catch up with him. You've seen it in the last two rounds. Binder, if you can beat him up a bit, it makes it harder for him. It's as simple as that. He's got the speed to break away. As we see there, Philip Hertl again trying to go up the inside of Bastianini.
Yeah, Bastianini was just out a fraction wide, running over the curbs, coming out of turn six. Hertl thought about a look up the inside of him at turn seven. Championship standings as is right now. Brad Binder will be 64 points clear ahead of Jorge Navarro if the checkered flag is thrown out now. But Navarro is advancing at a fairly rapid rate towards the top six. He's currently running in ninth. He's piling the pressure on Jorge Martin now in seventh place.
Thumbs up from the pit board of Brad Binder, but across the line we go. He's faster than the group behind him. There he is, number 41. He leads with nine laps to go. Then it's Quartararo, then it's Philip Hertl, up the inside of Bastianini, who we're now on board with.
It's so funny what happens when a faster rider comes flying past you. The Gian Antonio, Buliger and Bagnaia were riding really slowly, dropped back into the clutches of Navarro. Now they're tagged in behind Navarro. All three of them, the Gian Antonio, Buliger and Bagnaia, the three Italians have just put in their personal best laps of the race. All of a sudden, out of nowhere, they found a second and a half.
out of turn number three. And downhill we go. Quartararo might have just closed that gap a bit to Brad Binder, the race leader. We'll see in a moment as they drop downhill into turn four. There is Binder.
We've got marshals up at turn three, Steve. I think we've had a four at turn three, a little bit further down the field. I'm sure I saw a couple of marshals running across the grab, the tarmac runoff there. So I'm not sure if we've had a four at turn number three.
Just looking to see whether we can spot who it is. I'm not sure. Where is Rodrigo. Maria Herrera? It's Rodrigo, is it? Ah, Rodrigo gone down there, not for the first time this season. 8.5 laps to go. Binder, it is that leads. You're looking at the battle for six on screen at the moment. Number 55, Locatelli, up ahead of Jorge Navarro. This is much more like it. Navarro, though, has got work to do once he gets past Locatelli, because there is a gap here up ahead. Well, look at that. He made light work of Locatelli. There's confirmation of what Matt said. Rodrigo down, Jorge Martin then goes through as well. He follows Jorge Navarro. Now, what can the Spaniard do? Second in the World Championship, desperate to become a part of the chasing pack. Here we are back with the leaders across the line. Still Binder that leads. The gap is down to under 0.2.
Philip Hurtl has just set the best lap of the race at 1:36.557. Jorge Navarro won't be thinking about the painkillers now. He's riding on pure adrenaline alone. Hurtl's going to get a great slipstream behind Brad Binder as they come through the fast kink at turn number two, and Hurtl gets a great draft. He takes the lead, then the German hits the front for the first time. Quartararo also used the slipstream to move up the inside of Binder, and he brilliantly moves aside Hurtl. Quartararo though in a little bit too hot. Binder went from third going into turn number three. He's come out of it leading the race.
Quartararo will have a look up the inside here into turn four, but that's not if the beast has anything to say about that as well. Here we go down into turn four. Binder leads. Bastianini now up into second place.
What Quartararo keeps doing, Steve, at turn number three is great late on the brakes, but to make the apex, he has to really, really pull it up tight, and he loses all of his momentum, sacrifices all of his exit speed. In doing so, he compromises his own pace, and he also messes up a couple of other riders behind him.
Binder's attempt to try and pull away at the front, let's be honest, were pretty good, a good effort, but not quite worked out for him, and with eight laps to go, he has company again. Andrea Bastianini now in second place with Fabio Quartararo all over his tail. Philip Hurtl having one of the races of his life there in fourth place, and then Joan Mir, who wants his first ever Grand Prix podium. Binder is the rider you would put your money on to still win this race, but they're far, far closer than they were a few laps ago.
Navarro in sixth place is now 2.9 seconds behind this lead group of five as they come over the line to complete lap number 16. It's Binder by the width of a front wheel over the line against Quartararo. Quartararo then up the inside of Binder into turn one. The slipstream effect coming into use there again. So Binder back to third with Bastianini taking second place.
What Binder's always been so clever at doing this season is if he does get bumped back a place or two, immediately biting back, and that's what he's trying to do now as he goes back past Andrea Bastianini. Into turn three we go, and Binder now having a look and a lunge up the inside. Brilliantly done from the World Championship leader. He runs it wide a bit though, and that allows Quartararo through. Almost a carbon copy, but in reverse of what happened the previous lap.
Mir again getting a bit erratic on the brakes into turn three. Really picked up Andrea Bastianini, who had no choice but to run wide. Bastianini now is in danger of dropping back to fifth place again because he's under pressure from Philip Hurtl.
Brad Binder has just got ability to overtake pretty much wherever he wants.
Well, he's the master tactician, isn't he? His strategy this year, invariably, has been absolutely spot on. Quartararo has a look up the inside of Binder at turn six. No way through this time around.
Now he's got to try and get the drive on out of turn eight and then maybe launch an attack down into turn nine. On board here with Bastianini in fourth.
And here, Bastianini's operating deep behind enemy lines in KTM's backyard. He's the lone Honda challenger in this lead group of five.
I don't think he cares.
He's the odd one out, but he won't care.
Down into turn nine we go then. Bastianini here in fourth. Just up ahead of him is Joan Mir as we now drop down into the lowest point of the circuit, turn 10, before the climb again. Across the line it will be Brad Binder that leads once more with six laps to go, with a couple of Leopard KTM riders really hot on his tail. They're going to try and go either side of him. Binder tries to take the defensive line, and it works. Quartararo drops down to third, Mir up to second.
Yeah, good tactical ride there by Binder. You can see him weaving all over the track, just trying to defend that lead into the first corner. Back with Jorge Navarro, who started to break away from Jorge Martin. Livio Loy's just put in his personal best lap of the race. He's in eighth place as Quartararo again looks up the inside. Will he make it stick this time around? No, it's Mir. Oh, Bastianini got a little bit untidy on the brakes going into turn number three. Managed to gather it all back up. Now, look at the slipstream effect there, Steve. Binder came out of turn one leading. He's now back in fourth.
This is as far back as Binder's been in the race so far. And because Bastianini went so slow through turn three, it's just meant that he's going to have to stay there for now. And he's going wide. He's gone way too hot down into turn four. He'll stay on board, but he'll drop down to fifth place. The first major mistake we've seen from anyone here in the top four in this race. And it's Binder who drops to fifth.
Yeah, Binder in way, way too hot downhill at turn number four.
The ears will prick up there for Jorge Navarro as well. He's there in sixth place and he knows exactly who's right in front of him now.
Yeah, the gap between Binder and Navarro down to 1.3 seconds. A rare, rare mistake then from the South African, the world championship leader. And as Steve said, all the incentive that Navarro needs. He started this race in 17th place. Now he is up inside the top six. He's only 6 tenths of a second now, 1.1 seconds rather behind Binder.
We've got three riders in the top four here who have never had a Grand Prix victory, and they are all looking to do it here with five laps to go. Across the line we go. Look at this. They're all just, you never know what to expect of these guys that are hanging out the pit boards, but most of them are pretty happy. It's Joan Mir that leads from Bastianini and Quartararo. There is Jorge Navarro as he goes out of turn number one, doing a brilliant job now he's settled into this race.
Yeah, that mistake on the brakes down into turn four, Steve, cost Brad Binder 1.2 seconds. Has it cost him the chance to take another victory? He can get back in this fight, no doubt about that. Because what's going to happen is Bastianini, who's now trying to fight away around the outside, that's a bit ambitious in the extreme by Anea Bastianini. He runs it way, way wide. This is perfect for Binder, because while these leading four just keep throwing it up the inside of each other,
Navarro's gone. Lines. Navarro's gone down the order, Matt, I'm afraid. And I think he might have even dropped out of the race altogether. Falling. It's happened at turn three. Oh, no, and this here is the worst possible news for the Spaniard, and that could be the moment where we say goodbye to the championship for Jorge Navarro. Oh, he's doing such a great job there in seventh place, but Jorge Navarro is out of the Austrian Grand Prix. He's trying desperately to get that bike started again. He may well rejoin, but he'll be out of the points. On board of him here, into turn three, a bit wide, too wide.
Yeah, a bit wide. It's a little bit rough and bumpy as well on the entry to that turn number three. And you have to say, that's a massive, massive blow for his world championship aspirations. I'm sure Binder will be getting aboard pretty soon about Navarro. He can't get that Honda going again. It's a pretty disconsolate walk away with the medical team for Navarro. And if Brad Binder, well, if the checkered flag gets thrown now with Binder in fifth, it will be a 58-point lead in the world championship for Binder, but it could get even better because he's just set his personal best lap of the race on lap number 19. Binder down to 1:36.80. He was about half a second quicker than the four riders in front of him, Dylan.
Well, guys, his team, they've just shown him the pit, but they still haven't told him that Navarro is out just yet.
No, well, that was actually going to be my next question, Dylan, so you're one step ahead of me there, mate. But here we go into turn number three. The two Leopard Racing riders desperate for wins. Like you say, with Binder, regardless as to what's happened to Navarro, what's going to bring him back into contention is the fact that there are three riders here that are desperate for their first ever Grand Prix win. And then Anea Bastianini is desperate to get back on form. And here he comes, the South African rider. This might get a bit tight into turn four. Oh, Fabio Quartararo really lost out there and has been bumped back to fifth place. Mir leads from Ertl. And then it's Brad Binder in third.
Brilliant by Binder up the inside of Quartararo and Bastianini at turn number four. He got it horribly wrong on the last lap, got it absolutely perfect this time around. Brad Binder doesn't tend to make the same mistake twice.
On board here with Anea Bastianini as he chases down through turn eight, Brad Binder. Look at this, they're into the slipstream and then they'll drop down into turn number nine. There's Philipp Ertl launching an attack for the race lead and does so. The German leads here in Austria. He said it was pretty much a home race for him. What a result this would be for the KTM rider as they dip down into turn 10 and there will be four laps to go as they cross the line. Ertl has it just from Joan Mir.
Binder then back in third place.
Are they giving Joan Mir the... No, sorry, I was going mad then. I thought they were giving Joan Mir the wrong information. He goes up into the lead. Three laps to go as they cross the line and up towards turn number three. Watch Binder here. Watch Brad Binder, number 41, in third place as Bastianini goes so close to the grass. On board with Bastianini now as he chases on Brad Binder. And look at that. Mir has gone from first to third and maybe even further back as Bastianini lunges up the inside here. Where's Binder gone? Has he gone wide? Bastianini leads.
Yeah, Binder almost went into the mountains there. He's dropped back to fourth place. Philipp Ertl Well, he led over the line. He's now in fifth place. Shout out to Livio Loy, the Belgian, doing a great job back in sixth place.
Binder's wide again. He's made the same mistake again. Down at turn four. This time not quite as costly, but two mistakes. Lightning does strike twice for Brad Binder there. You're right about Livio Loy doing a great job. Who's going to win this race? There were 2.5 laps to go. So many hungry riders at the front end of this. What Binder does not want to do, of course, is throw it down the road with his championship rivals gone. There you see again, running really wide into turn number four. And Philip Ertl, that's the reason why he dropped back. That's turn three, sorry. So Ertl really losing out there.
Steve, this is as erratic as I've seen Brad Binder all year. I'm just wondering if he's having a few issues with that front tyre. It's perhaps something that run into a bit of grip problems. It's a very hard abrasive circuit, certainly on the front end with so many harsh downhill braking points. He's certainly not out of contention for the victory. They come over the line to start the penultimate lap. Mia from Bastianini, Quartararo, Binder and Ertl. Is any one of these five?
We are going to see some celebrations soon. Nicolò Antonelli's been given some orders from race control to change a position for a penalty. We've not even mentioned his name in this race. He's so far back, of course, still nursing that collarbone injury. But this is the battle we want to see at the front. This is the battle for the victory with two laps to go at the front. On the brakes, Enea Bastianini leads. Number 33 from Juan Mir and Fabio Quartararo. In fourth place, Brad Binder in fifth. Philip Ertl, then a gap back to Livio Loy, to Gianantonio and Martin.
Imagine that Antonelli and Jakob Kornfather has also got to drop one position. They've probably been exceeding the track limits on more than one occasion. That's usually the penalty. If you do keep exceeding the track limit, you're asked to just drop one position, which is easier said than done when you're in a group that's battling like this of about 10 riders. Binder back up to third at the front of the field.
Yeah, we want to see that fight at the front of this race now with a lap and a half to go. Nico Antonelli's way back. He ain't scoring any points today. But who is it that's going to fight for the victory here in Austria? This is the leading group. Juan Mir from Enea Bastianini and Brad Binder will not go away ever in this championship in third. You wouldn't count him out of winning this one again, would you? Fabio Quartararo now tries to find a way past him, but he stays in fourth. Mir leads.
Under severe pressure from Bastianini as they drop down through turn number 10 to start what will be the final lap, lap number 23. It will be Mir over the line then at the end of lap 22 from Bastianini, from the world championship leader Binder. Philip Ertl trying to use the slipstream behind Fabio Quartararo. Mir strong enough on the brakes into turn number one. He holds the lead.
This is so important now with 2.6 miles left off this race. Fabio Quartararo there in fourth is desperate to try and get in the slipstream of Binder to put himself in contention for the race win. Binder there in third. Can he get the double slipstream? Here comes Bastianini strong on the brakes up into turn three. Such an important overtaking manoeuvre. And here comes Binder, the championship leader. Perfectly done from third up into first place when it counts.
Yeah, but did he lose crucial drive against Juan Mir? They're three abreast as they run down to turn number four. This is where Binder's had a few problems on the brakes. It's Bastianini that leads the way. Quartararo tried to move to the inside line. Mir's getting it a little bit out of shape on the brakes. Binder goes through, squeezes Bastianini out onto the kerb. Binder then leads. Oh, Mir brilliantly back up the inside, as is Quartararo. Binder back to third.
Sheer grit and determination from Juan Mir there to take the lead and push the championship leader wide as they drop down now into turn six and seven. Brilliantly done there.
Well, there's only really one breaking point left.
Wow.
Brilliant by Binder up the inside. He mugs Quartararo through turn number seven. He's lining up a move on Juan Mir down the hill into turn number nine. Has Mir done enough, though? He's got five or six bike lengths on Binder. This could be Mir's race. Binder won't give it up. Mir comes into turn number 10. He still has the lead.
This is brilliantly done then. Here we go. Just a couple of corners left and now into the final turn. They can't get on terms with Brad Binder. Juan Mir is going to win his first race. We've not seen a winner since from pole position since Misano. We have now. Mir wins his first ever Grand Prix across the line from Brad Binder. And Enea Bastianini it is that takes third place. Fabio Quartararo misses out in fourth and Philip Ertl in fifth place. What a ride from Mir. And I tell you what, it was that move he slung underneath Brad Binder on the exit of turn four that did it. He thoroughly deserves that.
What a ride, what a last lap by the 18-year-old Spaniard. Brilliant performance by Mir, finally ending the pole jinx in Moto3, as Steve said. 14 Grand Prix since Enea Bastianini's win from pole in Misano. What a last lap by Mir. Binder, a great second place. Brilliant for his world championship chances. Bastianini, a third podium in four races for the Italian. Quartararo and Ertl, the two that just missed out. Jorge Martin took his career best sixth place. Bench Schneider, seventh. Gian Antonio, eighth. Bulliger, ninth. Livio Loi got pushed back on the last lap to 10th. Bagnaia, Guevara, Locatelli, Herrera and Ohno were your point-scoring finishers.
Do you know, this is great to see. He's the first rookie of the season to take a win, and it just shows you what sort of a character Joan Mir is, because every rider, every rookie going over to congratulate him, because he is genuinely a lovely lad, very approachable in the paddock. Brad Binder here, well, I tell you what, you have to take a bow to this guy. He is unbelievable. Brad Binder, his championship lead now increases. He did everything he could to still try and win that race. I don't think he would have even been given a signal about Navarro, but we'll find out later on. Bastianini, like you say, on the podium again. But it's all about the 18-year-old Mallorcan, Joan Mir, who missed out, agonisingly missed out, on the CEV Junior World Championship last year. He was in the running, it didn't happen for him. He's been bashed about a bit so far early in the season. All about qualifying, isn't it? And look, he got himself on pole. He was in contention throughout. He made a right nuisance of himself throughout that race, and he reaps the rewards.
Yeah, he got a bit erratic at times, but on the last lap, he was silky smooth. When Binder got up the inside of Quartararo through turn number seven with a real ambitious move, you thought, hang on a minute, Binder's going to have a lunge up the inside here at turn number nine. But the drive that Mir got through turns number eight, Fabio Quartararo, well, I would say we've got a fairly frustrated Frenchman there, because even though he's finished in fourth place, which is by far his best result of a pretty frustrating season, well, he has stormed straight through the Leopard KTM garage. I suppose rubbing salt into the wounds a little bit is the fact that your teammates just carved you up and taken a victory.
There are going to be cameras and people coming to interview Joan Mir all day, and when you've been in the race for the win and your teammate rookie wins it, it's going to be so frustrating. And I think he'll calm down. He's the type of character that will cool down. He'll reflect on it and realise, you know what, he was in the race to win, and this is a new Fabio Quartararo. But you can't take anything away. Anything goes in these Moto3 races.
Not the result that Red Bull would have wanted, with a rival energy drink taking the victory. Certainly certainly a result that KTM would have wanted, of course, in their home Grand Prix here in Austria. Joan Mir, well, that's the way to celebrate your first Grand Prix victory. Brilliant. What a perfect weekend for him. Pole position, race win. Doesn't get much better than that. He's up to seventh place in the World Championship now. He's only 6 points behind an A of Bastianini inside the top six.
So brilliant racing.
Good rides in there, wasn't there, Steve? Yeah. Philip Ertl in fifth, and Bo Benschneider in seventh place. Some of the rookies are really starting to come to the fore. And as we said, Maria Herrera, great to see her back in action after that wrist injury in Germany. And she's inside the points in 14th place.
67-point lead in the championship for Brad Binder. That is not going to be easy. I don't think anyone will catch him.
I think Joan Mir will be probably, they're doing some testing here in Moto2 and Moto3 tomorrow, but I think on Tuesday he's going to go to the KTM factory, walk in, and they're going to say, well, take whatever you want, mate.
It's always wonderful to see a first win for anyone in Grand Prix racing. Always wonderful to see, because it's one that you just know they'll never, ever, ever forget it. And what a place to do it at as well. The beautiful Red Bull Ring here in Spielberg.
Yeah, Joan Mir first came to our attention at World Championship level when he had a replacement ride at Phillip Island last year. Phillip Island, one of the hardest tracks to learn, one of the fastest and most technical tracks on the calendar. And before he got in a tangle with John McPhee, he was actually running inside the top six and doing a great job. So we shouldn't be too surprised. Philip Ertl, well, that's as close as he's come to a podium finish this year. He was only 0.6 of a second behind Joan Mir at the chequered flag. A great fifth place. First top 10 for the German since the opening round of the championship. We're going to hear, though, from the man in third place. A third podium in the last four races for that man there. And they are Bastianini.
Well, Anaya, you were up there fighting with the lead group almost all race long. You're back on the podium again. But going into that final turn, you were fourth. How confident were you could get past Fabio?
Yeah, I'm not happy for this third position, because today my bike was fast and me so fast, but the last lap Binder passed me very, very fast and me go large. Nothing. I'm happy, but not happy.
Thank you very much, Anaya. Congratulations.
Well, he says he's going large. What's Joan Mir going to be doing tonight after that career first victory? Anaya Bastianini preventing KTM from a clean sweep of the podium in the Austrian Grand Prix. Pit Barra there on the left, of course, so influential in KTM. Brad Binder didn't take the victory in KTM's home race for Red Bull, but in terms of his world championship aspirations, with Romano Fenati suspended and Jorge Navarro crashing out, it's still been a great day for the South African, and he's talking to Dylan.
Well, Brad, you managed to salvage second place, a great move up in turn number seven, but it looked like you were struggling a little bit with the front, sort of going wide, turn three, turn four. How difficult was it out there in those conditions?
You know, I had the same problem the whole race. I felt it this morning and, you know, we didn't understand exactly what it was. Every time in the really slow corners when I opened the throttle, the engine would go, whoa. And then it would wait a while and then the power would come in. And, you know, I noticed if I really try to roll on the throttle quite slowly, I wouldn't have this flat spot. So, you know, I struggled a lot because every time on all the exits of the corners, I lost a lot of time. But, you know, luckily, I mean, thank you so much to my team because the bike they gave me for braking is absolutely incredible.
Thank you very much, Brad. Congratulations.
Well, when you've had the struggles that Brad Binder had in that race to come away with 20 points, they'll be absolutely gold for his championship challenge. Jorge Navarro just going through the post-mortem of what was a really difficult day for him. He climbed back up into contention for the podium with a superb charge through the field from 17th place on the grid, but a crash at turn number three puts a massive dent in his championship challenge. 67 points now, the gap between Binder and Navarro. What a day though for Joan Mir, his career first Grand Prix victory, and he's going to tell us all about it now with Dylan in Parc Fermé.
Well, Joan, you started from pole position and you've won your first Grand Prix. How does it feel?
Well, amazing. How can I say about this weekend? No, perfect since the free practice one. We work a lot with the team and thanks to the team. And also, together we work very well and this is the result, no? Incredible. Thanks to my team.
Thank you very much, Joan. Congratulations.
Of course, I mentioned he was the first rookie to win, forgetting Khairul Adampawi. How could I forget Khairul Adampawi? A double race winner in the wet. But either way, another rookie takes another win. It's great to see. And this might just kickstart the rest of the campaign for Joan Mir. These rookies, it's all about next year more than anything else. It's about gaining experience, ready to try and win the championship in 2017. And Joan Mir has thrown himself right in the pack. This is the race to the line then. Mir, home and dry, Binder second, very close for third. That's probably what really annoyed Fabio Quartararo more than anything else. He went across the line 0.008 of a second. And let's be honest, Matt, it's not the first time it's happened to him. He got mugged in Mugello as well.
He did, yeah, Quartararo. And as we say, what makes it smart even more is the fact that your Leopard KTM teammate is about to be popping open the car on the top step of the podium. No podium in over a year still then for Quartararo. Dutch TT in Assen. Pretty long drought by his standards.
He's got to take comfort from the fact that he's back again. That's the best performance from Quartararo that we've seen this season so far. And a brilliant ride for Philipp Hertl. We can't forget that. The German rider going across the line. Poor Philipp Hertl. 0.6 of a second from the winner, Joan Mir, and he ends up in fifth place. Jorge Martin, good result. Ben Schneider, seventh place. What a day.
I think that's his best ever finish, isn't it? Was he ninth in Assen?
Correct, yeah. Brilliant stuff from the Dutchman. He's getting better and better.
He's coming to the fore.
Bad start for him, though. That was the big problem today.
When you look at the likes of Ben Schneider, Joan Mir, the performances of Bulliger and Powy this year, it just shows how these feeder classes into the World Championship are unearthing some great hot young talent. The Chalabante Asia Talent Cup, the Junior World Championship, the CV Series in Spain, the Red Bull Rookies MotoGP Cup. It really is a brilliant proving ground for all these young talent to get them the experience, the knowledge before they head into the viper's nest, really, of MotoGP World Championship.
Well, it's the 10th anniversary of the Red Bull Rookies, and the inaugural winner of that championship was Johann Zarco. And Johann Zarco, of course, currently Moto2 World Champion. So it just goes to show you that proving ground from the start really does work. Bo Benschneider, of course, last year's Red Bull Rookie Champion. will try and fight for the championship. I tell you what, it's shaping up to be an interesting one next year with all the rookies going on for another year with a bit of experience at all the circuits.
Yeah, summer days, happy days for Leopard KTM. Of course, they're on the podium with Andrea Locatelli's first ever world championship podium 4 weeks ago in Germany in the Sachsenring, where they've gone one better today. This is what I like about some of these teams as well. When one of the riders gets on the podium, the other rider goes down to join in the celebration. It shows a bit of unity. Ben Schneider. I don't think it's going to be too long before we see him fighting for that podium as well. He was only 4.1 seconds off the victory at the checkered flag. So he really is starting to come to the fore. Mia, Ben Schneider, Gian Antonio and Bulliger, four rookies inside the top 10.
Mark Webber just on the left there. Mark will be handing out a trophy or two, I'm sure.
Yeah, former Red Bull Formula One driver, of course. Massive, massive motorcycle race fan, Mark Webber. Saw him at Valencia last year, where he wasn't hiding his allegiance to Valentino Rossi in the championship battle against Jorge Lorenzo. It's all about Austrian Moto3.
He's not the only Formula One driver here either. Austrian former Formula One driver Gerhard Berger is here as well. Him and Mark were hovering around the paddock yesterday. What a great first race to open the day up then on our return to Austria, with three different flags on the podium, three different nationalities, three different riders, and of course, despite the fact that it might not be a Red Bull rider on top step, KTM at least have got a race winner here to open the day with.
A jubilant Juan jumps onto the top step of the podium. Here come KTM management to receive the Constructor Trophy. Great home victory for KTM. Leopard Racing team representatives taking the team prize for Juan Mir. Here's third place then for Enea Bastianini. His 12th career podium finish. And he's coming right back into contention for third place in the championship. He's only 12 points now behind fellow Italian Romano Fenati. What a day though for the South African Brad Binder. There is Mark Webber handing over the trophy to Binder. His 14th world championship podium. 67 points now clear of Jorge Navarro in the world championship. It's his to lose in the final eight races of the season. But there is the FIM president, Vito Ippolito, about to hand over a first ever winner's trophy for Juan Mir. Congratulations then to the teenage Spaniard, Juan Mir. He becomes the 21st rider to take a victory in the Moto3 World Championship, joining Spaniards like Luis Alon, Maverick Viñales, Efren Vasquez, Jorge Navarro. Pretty decent club to be joining.
To say thanks to our colleagues over at World Superbike. Steve English has just sent me a text message, commentator World Superbike, and he said it's the five first-time winners this year in Moto3, which is more than any other year since 2005, when there were six with Simon, Pizzini, Luti, Talmashi, Callio and D'Amelio. So we've already had five first-time winners in 2016, and we've got another eight rounds still to go.
Yeah, Casey Stoner here as the ambassadorial role for Ducati. I think he enjoyed that one. What another great Moto3 race. The double MotoGP world champion has just tweeted. I don't think anybody around the world that's just watched that captivating race will disagree with Casey Stoner. And quite right, nobody could have called that race. Anyone really, that top five, Mir, Binder, Bastianini, Quartararo and Ertl, could have taken the 25 points. It's getting pretty tight, that battle, actually, for second place in the world.